This is going to be introductory video into the time-lapse portion. You'll see the work being done. Not going to do much explaining, just going to get it all built, backed up into a wall of time here. Fish are in the trash can, which ironically people thought I literally threw my fish away and not that I put water in the trash can. So that was kind of funny. It's like I had a couple people react that way. So changes that we made, there's actually quite a few changes. There was a bag full of PVC parts that I put together back in September, and I found them out in the garage, and I was like, well, I need returning to Lowe's, along with the blue pipe or the blue hose that you guys saw me grab. I'm not using that because that's for pressurized water systems for like your water in your yard, and the inner diameter is not half inch. It's actually a little less, 3/8 or maybe even less, depending on which one I had. And I noticed they're pretty constricted. So I would have greatly reduced the flow in the system. So what I did was I went out and I picked up these fittings from the sprinkler section. These are Schedule 80, so they can do a lot of pressure if you wanted them to. But basically, they're half-inch thread, and then they're half-inch barb, and the inner diameter is pretty close to a half-inch. It's not too far off. So we're not going to lose as much flow restriction as we would have lost going the other way. The other thing is we're not using this anymore. This is actually two parts, 3/4 thread to half. The new part I picked up is basically this 3/4 thread here, and then it's half inch female thread on the inside. And basically it's going to thread into each of these four spots right here, which I do have two of them in there. We're going to see a size comparison, how much space we're saving. So one of the important things when you guys set up your aquariums is you want to have as little stuff as possible in the aquarium. Unfortunately, mine's going to get a little complicated here in the center, but I do have a plan for that. I'm going to make a nice rockscape because I have lots of slate from a lake. So I'm going to drill into it and kind of assemble it into like a house type thing. So the plecos are going to love it. I'm sure those fish are going to love it, and then maybe the hill streams will love it if I use a smoother rock. I don't know if I've got any. Got a bunch of rock out in the yard, too. So we went to see PVC parts, as we all know, in the center here. I returned a bunch of PVC parts, ordinary ones, which were big, bulky. That's why I went to see PVC. Does the same job. And basically, let's talk about the hoses that I made. We're only going to have four. Actually, we're going to have six of these total in the tank. So what I did is I just pushed them on and zip tied a really, really good zip tie on each end. I'm not going to do the metal fittings. They do rust over time and they're also sharp. And the one thing I did to get rid of the sharp edges on here is you can file them, but you can also take a wrench and then you can basically twist on it and then it'll tear off right here. So another important thing we're going to cover, I've been thinking about it. In fact, I think my mom might have suggested it, is to put gravel in the space between the glass and the acrylic boxes, and that'll keep the sand from going in there and blocking these tiny tapered holes we drilled in with a stepper bit a long time ago. So this should allow the sand to kind of sit on top. Some might fall in, but there'll be the water pushing on it, so it shouldn't really go down to clog it. Even if it did, this should give enough buffer. Another important thing to talk about, because my plans were initially to have about a 1/4 inch space between all of the boxes and everything, and that ended up not occurring because we have these plastic covers that I put on the edges, which were a very good idea, but what they did end up doing is they ended up closing the gap, and they're also on the end, it's pushed up against the glass. It's not form fitted, but it's there. So not much room for water to flow. So I think what we're going to end up seeing is water is going to come out the front, back in the middle here, front, back in the corners, and we might have a little bit of tumbling, or that will just be not very entertaining to begin with. Then we're going to put the A-crate on top of all of this. Probably going to cut it in sections because I got the hoses. The idea behind the A-crate is to protect against things like this. This is actually pretty heavy. Like right now, it's probably, with these two rocks on there, a good 15 pounds with the wood. Now this wood totally dried up, so I'm actually going to be able to push some plants in there, and as it waters up again, hopefully they stay this time. And then heavier rocks as well. The other important thing too about the rocks is we're going to use the A crate and a combination of the CPVC pipes, and we're going to kind of stand them up off of the A crate. This will give the sand a place to go, and it won't create a uneven weight in sand, so the water will just start pushing sand out, and then I have a crater there, and then the system isn't going to work as intended right off the get-go. So the plan is to have all of the rocks and the decorations basically about that far under the surface of the sand, and under it's just going to be a foundation. It's going to be pretty cool when I'm done with it. And I'm going to just use a concrete bit, I think, to drill those, and wooden dowels or plastic dowels, something like that. So I'm going to take you guys for a walk into the aquarium here, and we're going to see what it looks like on the inside. Okay, trying to get as much light in here as possible. That's just not working out very well. So we're going to cover this guy right there. So as you can see there, the part on the left here is the old fittings that probably aren't going to be used. The new one is there on the right. And then as we pan up towards the middle there, you're going to notice that the flex seal looks kind of bad. And that was because I was running out of flex seal at this point, after doing all of the other pipe settings and stuff like that. But as you go up, it does smooth out, but it's much better here at the top. So the important part that you might look at is taken care of. So maybe we'll get some algae and stuff that grows on there and the fish will like it. This is completely removable, by the way. I don't know if I did a segment on those, but those are all threaded here, so I could pull these off anytime. However, I noticed they're extremely difficult to remove because of these fittings down there, so you can't really turn them. So if I had to remove them in the future, I could basically cut them straight off. And one of the ideas I do have is I want to get a hold of a pipe threading tap set. It would be very beneficial because I wouldn't need all these fittings to actually pull off what I'm doing. So it's something I'm really thinking about doing down the road, and I can eliminate a lot of excess parts in the process. So here is the long shot of what we're looking at. Let's make sure we're all focused. So it looks really cool to me. I think it's good. I hope everybody else likes the idea behind it. The whole purpose of this is pretty simple, and I'll explain that in a moment once you're not moving around. Here's the gap a little bit. You can see it better right here. It's about a half inch gap, and what you're seeing is silicone that the aquarium was built with initially. So we're going to do a little bit of a walk here, wandering. Okay. Let's get you back on the tripod. So with that said, got the idea of what we're going to do. The rest of it's going to be time-lapsed as best as I can, and you're probably going to be seeing a lot of my back, so I think I'm going to probably put like the camera over here and point it down at the sides that I'm working on. That way you guys can see what's going on, and if I do it right, I might be able to just have both things going on at the same time where you can see them both being done. With that said, thanks for watching the intro video, the rest of your time-lapse video, and then maybe a hooray at the end of the time-lapse video that it all got done. We'll find out. And then maybe the fish gets in the tank by tomorrow or the next day. Plants will certainly be in here by tomorrow, hopefully, once the pump and everything's put in. But with that said, thanks for watching.